Welcome back, everyone, to the WCG North American Finals here between Fulcrum and Bern. They're going to be facing off against one another here in three best of fives. I'm Golden Boy. This is Frank the Show.
What's up, guys?
And it seems like the countdown has begun.
That's right.
For them.
I learned something already.
Yeah,
turns out the format. They have 2 minutes to pick their tanks.
Yeah.
And then they go from there. Once that timer's done, it's go time. They're ready to rumble.
Ready to jam.
Yeah.
Okay, so... yeah, so it seems like these guys are going to be picking any second now as in regards to like what tanks they're going to go with.
Yeah.
I'm expecting to see a couple of tier ones, being used as scout tanks and whatnot. We're going to see the level of play. I think the first map also is going to be Abbey with the with the town in the center there. That's going to be a big focal point there of the action.
Definitely.
And again, guys, if you want to fill us in on any info and all that stuff, feel free to let us know in the chat. We have guys looking at that. Frank's taking a look at that as well. He's got it up. So if you want to yell at us, you could yell at us. That's fine. You can also hit us up as well on our individual Twitters, at GoldenBoyFTW and at FrankTheShow. His is probably a little easier to remember, perhaps. But it seems like the tanks have been chosen here. And we have the T1, the IS, two IS3s, T69s, three T69s, and actually two T1s here on each side. That's going to be for, if I'm correct, that would be for Bern, all Empires. And then on the Fulcrum side, what do they got?
So it looks like the main difference here is between the IS3 and then Fulcrum going to be running an AMX 1390, which looks like a pretty utilizing tank there.
Yeah, there we go.
Provide a lot. I'm interesting to see.
Man,
what's up, man?
Let's do it. All right, let's go ahead up into the game action here, and let's see what we have. Of course, this is all relatively new to all of us.
Right.
But, we're just going to have some fun.
Absolutely.
The battle starts in a couple seconds here. There you can actually see.
Get a nice field of view of those tanks there. Ugh, look at that monster.
Let me see which one right here.
So I'm expecting teams to kind of push lanes here, almost similar if you're familiar with MOBAs or any sort of FPS, really. I mean, positioning is always going to be important. So one could surmise that they're going to want to push out towards different sides and sort of take flanks, take angles on that enemy team as you see these guys rolling out there.
Yeah, and I'm going to be, by the way, in the perspective here of Bern, so that's who we're going to be taking a look at here.
All right.
And the red squad, of course, is going to be Fulcrum. And I think we got confirmation that Fulcrum did, in fact, win last year and go to represent the United States.
Excellent.
So we'll see off the break here what's going on as we hop on board here with Rill, as he's going to be rocking that T1, doing the best that he can to make his way around and get some angles.
Yeah, and on my perspective here, Fulcrum F0X has pushed up to the top right side of that mini-map, and he is just scouting out, looking for anyone to come down that path. Isn't going to spot anyone yet. Relics hovering around the top left side of their base, and these guys must be sort of like anchoring, just holding back and watching that position for any possible flanks for the Fulcrum squad.
Yeah, that's right, and actually we have a couple units here moving to the left side. Of course, pressure is certainly going to be on here. No encounters just yet. As let me see, we have one guy actually trying to move in here on this sector. Let me actually see if I can find out who that is. I believe that's going to be the T1. Yes, it is. So that will be Hawk here, SBM Hawk. Who's trying to see if he can find anything here.
And it looks like Soviet, Negatron, and Friction are all hovering out in some heavy-duty bruisers for the Fulcrum squad, but haven't seen anyone yet on that map. But I'm screen cheating on your screen, and it looks like if they both just moved up a little bit towards the center of that map, they will have an engagement on their hands very, very soon.
Yeah, trying to see if I can get a good angle here and see what's going on. Of course, this is a brand new experience for me, man. I love the everything's just kind of like very intense here, where it's like the first encounter.
Yeah.
Of course, between these two teams, winner will go and represent the United States. Let's go ahead and see what's going on here with Azrael, as they're going to continue to advance on forward here on the left side. You can see that they're putting out some alerts there on the side, trying to, I guess there's some kind of attention going on over at E4, and I believe that is going to be coming from, let me see here, from Hawk, who still has not advanced forward just yet, but certainly the pressure is on as these guys are going to continue to advance on forward over to the left side, hopping on board here with Jojack. It's Jojack, Azrael, as well as G-Forcer trying to make something happen here on the left side, pushing very aggressive And it seems like both teams are kind of just circling around
each other. Actually, that's exactly what's happened. It's almost an exact mirror on my side of the map for Fulcrum. They pulled back to the top right, but it looks like we have an engagement going on there in the sort of bottom right area of the map where enemies have been spotted by this Fulcrum squad. Looks like 1-4 Burn is in the middle there, but he pulls out and retreats as Fulcrum is going to look to capitalize on knowing where the enemies are.
Yeah, that's right. And looking here, I could tell that Rill had the back up there, giving that attention. He scouted that people were coming through. There's actually going to be two tanks making their way around over here. This is not going to be a good look as F0X, as well as who is that there, Absolute Royal, are going to be turning around here, trying to get around, of course, those tier 8 tanks just tear right through Rill if he is not careful. But yeah, the pressure certainly is going to be on him. F0X, he's going to be using that T1 as well, trying to get around here, and they might be able to get away from this one. He needs to be careful about this player right over this hill.
That's right. And Soviet, I don't know if you can see him on your mini map, but he is in a real sneaky spot down by the lake on the bottom right. Confuse the letters there. But as we push up, we see Rill on my side of the screen, so he could be in line for an ambush right now.
All right, and I'm trying to see if I can go ahead and hop on board here with see what's up here. G-Force, no, we have, who's this here? Zone Delta is actually inside of the town, and he is going to come up on one in a little bit. Is that 74
Relics
health here as we're going to have an encounter? Zone's going to creep around the corner here. That is going to be Relics. His zone is going
to
go ahead and push through,
retreat,
and a great
blown up
shot there, able to take him out. I don't even know, was that a shot? Like, I'm confuzzled.
He's dead now.
He's dead now. I just used the word confuzzled in a broadcast.
The first casualty of war there, but F0X kind of
actually has a cap going on as well.
Yeah.
Too. Who is that capping right now?
Looks like F0X is making a run into this enemy base. Just trying to scout out.
Okay.
Yeah, but one is behind. Absolute Royal is now in the enemy base, waiting behind their lines. He looks like he's going to push back towards that
72
F0X
health
side
as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems like Jojak's trying to get a shot down on him. And, oh, great shot there by Jojak, able to take out Absolute Royal to close that one out. G-Forcer's going to actually get a piece of that as well. That was a great coordination attempt there by Jojak as well as G-Forcer to take him out. And already out the gate, we're seeing Burnall Empires looking solid here against Fulcrum in this first matchup. They're currently going to be up by 2, and they're giving an attention over here. And I'm actually going to go and hop on board here. This is going to be with Zone Delta, and let's see what's going on with him. There was an attention in this sector. I don't know if there was any activity going on over here, but nothing that I could see right now.
Yeah, and Negatron and Friction must have gotten the word that Burn has been hanging out in the middle, because they are moving in towards the center of that map, trying to get and engage as Hugo Maximus, which might be the coolest name I've ever heard.
I actually am thinking about naming my kid Hugo Maximus now.
Yeah, how
honestly
could you not? And look at this tank.
Pretty baller name.
So it looks like he's going to try to push in. He's just breaking through walls right now. He's the juggernaut, essentially. Getting shots on, looks like SBM Hawk towards the center of the map is still at 100%, so he didn't receive any damage there. But they definitely have him in their sights, and it looks like they're pushing to engage.
Yeah, I'm actually, okay, here we go. So, yeah, SBM Hawk, he's going to be in a little bit of a situation here. But, of course, it does seem like these guys did manage to move away here. Hawk trying to move in. Oh, there's a tank. That's actually going to be Hugo Maximus trying to advance forward with that tier 8 tank.
Break through.
And he might just try and power his way through here. Hawk is not going to be in a good position here. He needs to get away from this one, but he
Hugo
is going to be actually
hits.
Getting hit here. And that was going to be from Zone Delta, if I'm correct.
Yes.
As Hawk is going to be in a bit of a pickle. He needs to get behind this cover. And he's going to creep around the side. He's going to take him out. And that's going to do it.
Excellent peak
Hawk
shot
is going to get
from
taken
Hugo.
Out. Wow.
Just powering his way through. And a good notice, like Friction behind him also had the positioning in case Hugo was taken out to come through from behind. But just a sweet little pop-out play from Hugo there.
That's right. And shots are going to be exchanged here. And one of my favorite aspects of World of Tanks is how you need to be very tactical with your shots. But you can see here, Friction's going to be in a bad spot. He's going to get taken out by Zone Delta. That's going to be a big win for him as Maximus, 47 health for him, 47% on that health. Zone Delta might try and move in for the kill. Let's see if that is going to be the case here. And jumping over and highlighting these players to see who's going to get in a position to take out Hugo Maximus. That will be a big win Revenant trying to see if he can make something happen, getting a shot, not able to make anything happen with that one. Hopping on over to Zone Delta. Zone Delta advancing on forward, able to take him out for one. That's going to be a big hit, and he's going to nail him for another one. Can he get it? Yes, he does. Following it up, that's going to be a big win for Zone Delta, destroying Hugo Maximus. And now it is going to be down to just three members left of the Fulcrum crew in this first matchup here.
That's right, and with just barely over 2 minutes left to play,
F-Zero took out Rill.
Yeah, definitely looks like Burn is in a good position. Four tanks left up for Burn, three left for Fulcrum. Gonna be tough for them to recover from this because they have only a tier one tank and then two tier sevens left.
All right, let's make the mini-map bigger, guys. Oh. How big do you want the mini-map is the question.
And how do you make it smaller is the next question.
With the minus sign.
Right.
With the minus sign. Guys, we're in the chat, I just want to let you know, you are all amazing. Thank you so much for that. Of course, you know, we're going to do the best we can to provide quality entertainment here today, as there is going to be an attention over going on over by Sector 5. And let's see here. So apparently someone's been stuck for a while trying to drown himself.
Yeah.
And seems like that's going to do it there. All vehicles have been destroyed.
Yeah. So
okay.
Burn takes that first game.
Yeah, Burn does manage to take game number one here in this first matchup. That was quite intense. I was sweating.
Yeah.
I was sweating. You know, like, pretty cool stuff there. Let's see what we have. Let's see the detailed report. So we have, let's see here, personal score, team score now. Not bad. You know, taking a look here. Yeah, trying to get the lay of the land, learn what's going on. But all right, so already,
right,
Burn looking pretty solid against Fulcrum.
Yeah. So from my analysis, the kind of difference maker there is when they were both sort of rotating around the map. Fulcrum gave up that middle control to sort of push the right side.
Yeah.
And then Burn just sort of stayed in the middle and held that ground. So when Fulcrum tried to move in, they were basically walking into.
Yeah, and
the
also they also did have a guy who was not in a great position. He actually, I think he may have messed himself up and may have caused his team there. So
yeah,
he probably got in a terrible position. But needless to say, though, that's going to do it for that first one. I believe we're going to get this next one started here in just a bit. I guess we'll go ahead and jump it over to a brief break. And then when we come back, we're going to get game number two started in the first best of five here. We have three more best of fives to play. It's
right.
Actually first to two best of five, so we'll get to that in a little bit. I'm Golden Boy, this is Frank the Show. We'll
stay tuned.
You in a little bit.
Plantronics Gaming is proud to announce Rig, headset and mixer. This fall, games will come to life.
Take calls and keep playing. Game and voice chat. Stream your audio.
And life will come to games.
What's up?
Hey babe, just wondering if we're still on.
Mobile compatibility. Three EQ modes.
Seismic.
With detachable boom mic for listening on the go. Master the mix between gaming and life like never before.
All All right, guys, welcome back here to the WCG North American Finals between Fulcrum and Burn All Empires. I'm Golden Boy. This is Frank the Show, and thank you guys so much for your tips. Of course, keep bringing them.
Yeah,
keep bringing
them forward. We see you, Scoots.
Yeah, actually, you want to switch sides here, man? I want to switch sides.
Is there?
I want to jump over to the other.
Maybe asking a lot.
All right, we'll figure that one.
Yeah,
out. We'll work on that.
All right, we'll do it later.
We're going to switch sides in the next game, but I'm going to continue to follow here, Burn, and you're going to continue to follow Fulcrum.
Correct.
We're going to be playing on Himmelsdorf here, and we're going to be going live in just a bit. It seems like the Burn guys decided to go with the AMX 5100 here, that Tier 8 tank. They have about two of those there. Let's actually bring up the screen here so you can see what the tanks that they're going to be using. And there we go. So,
good stuff. All right. There.
Like this here.
So from what I've surmised, based on the last game, Fulcrum pushed up the middle and had two guys hang back on the left and right side of their base. So I'm going to be looking out for anything different that they do in response to Burn All Empires taking that first game off.
Yeah, I'm expecting this to be a bloodbath, by the way. I mean,
looks like a much smaller map. The lanes are much more defined.
Very small. Let's see who's going to be that team to draw first blood. That's going to be huge as we're going to kick it off here with Hawk from the Burn All Empire squad. Let's see what he's going to do. And already you can actually see here that Revenant, he's going to be getting real gutsy, moving up here alongside Rill. And they're going to see if they get this position up here at the right hill. That's going to be a good spot for them to get.
Yeah, and for Fulcrum, Friction and Hugo Maximus are poking out towards that top left of the mini-map there. Looks like they're going to be flanking around. Meanwhile, they have two other tanks in the middle with, I think it is, Relics scouting out towards the literal dead center of the map.
Oh boy, this is going to be intense. And it seems like there was an identification made. Hugo Maximus, as well as Soviet, have been identified here. And the person who is going to encounter them, let's go ahead and see who that will be. Oh man, that will be Hawk.
Yep, Friction paying no mind to these telephone poles, taking them all out as they are in hot pursuit of SV Hawk, who is quickly retreating back towards G-Forcer.
Yeah, and that, you know, that makes complete sense too. Also, Rill did manage to identify one, so there is going to be some pressure coming around here. And look at this here. You can see Hawk. He knows, man. He knows that they're going to be on the prowl. Friction as well as Hugo Maximus making their way around right inside of the base. There is going to be one player there waiting for that encounter. And like you said, that's G-Forcer.
Yeah.
He's going to be hanging out.
Friction and Hugo worried that they might be overextending here. If Burn is able to respond in time, they are pushed up very far into this base. While Burn seems to be located around that bottom right of the mini map, they are pushing in towards the bottom left and are encountering heavy fire from Zone and G-Forcer.
Oh man, look at that. There are shots exchanging here. 65% health left for, oh man, that's going to be Hugo Maximus. That's not a good look for him. G-Forcer, though, he's going to be stuck at 78%.
Yep.
I don't see anyone here trying to come around the flank. I could tell, though, that you are going to have at least Revenant as well as this is going to be Azrael trying to do their best to make their way down the street. And they did lose that identification there, so they do not see them. 797 HP remaining here for G-Forcer. Not the place where he wants to be. Let's go ahead, hop on board with Azrael here.
Yeah, and Hugo Maximus at 554 health, and he has actually taken cover behind not only just a building, but behind Friction as well, as he looks for G-Forcer to push around this corner here. They're just playing the waiting game as F-Zero is scouted out towards the back of Burn's base, and he is just in a tight little nook and cranny at this church structure.
And they actually are going to be waiting in this section right here. This is exactly where they're going to be hanging out there. Friction is going to be in a bad spot as Zone is going to push up. Let's go ahead, hop on board with Zone here. He's going to get aggressive, trying to make his way, taking out Soviet. 16% left here as Zone continuing to push on forward. And can he nail him? No, he cannot. Not closing that one out. And Soviet does manage to live to fight another day.
That's right.
Zone's going to be by himself here. And you can see that all of these guys are going to be pushing up right on this mid-street on the mini-map. Such tension going on here. Jojack might try and move in for an encounter.
Yeah, Absolute Royal doing a good job pushing up into position there to provide cover for Soviet, who is all the way down to 237 health. The next lowest being Hugo Maximus, who is... Another shot coming out. Absolute Royal taking some shots as well. Hugo Maximus does go down from an excellent shot by Zone Delta. As Jojack
is getting gully here, trying to move in.
The NFG push.
That is just not a good look here. And he is putting shots out all over the place. Joe Jack, 4% health remaining. He's going to move in, and he is going to get taken out. And now Revenant's going to be the last man standing here to try and make something happen, putting in some shots, and he is going to get dropped as well.
Man.
And that is going to end that round very quick, going in the favor of Fulcrum as they just dominate.
Huge play by Negatron there, ramming into that enemy tank to take him out. Just good awareness, good YOLOing.
Well, yeah.
Good YOLOing?
Well, I don't know if YOLOing is a technique, but I can tell you right now, that was what I saw there from Fulcrum was, I thought that they were going to be in a bad spot. I mean, they were pincered right in the middle, and then they came around. Then Jojack got reckless because he knew that they were just not in an advantageous position by any means whatsoever, and they ended up paying for it, thus losing that game. Now it's going to be 1-1 of the count here in the first best of five.
Yeah, and good awareness. I want to point out how impressed I was with Royal in that you had Hugo weak in the middle, Soviet weak in the middle, and he just zooms right in there to provide some extra cover and support for his team. So great play out of him.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that certainly was a great round there, and now they're going to be picking sides. So let's go ahead and see. I mean, I've really enjoyed in that encounter how, you know, and it seems like it's going to be Steps here, which is a pretty open map, by the way. So Steps is going to be the next battleground here. It seems like the sides have been picked. And I don't know if we know how to switch, but we'll learn eventually.
Yeah.
I think we'll switch it up for the next best of five. I'll hop on board with Fulcrum, show you guys some love there, and then he'll hop with Burn. But wow, that was great. That was great. Definitely really cool stuff here. So we're gonna wait for these teams to go ahead and pick their tanks in just a little bit. And I'm very interested. One thing that I find is to be really cool is how the action is so quick. Right? It's like, all right, here's your first round. It's going to be a little slow. Encounter. Boom.
Very
we're
going to
start shooting each other.
Yeah.
It's really cool stuff here. So I definitely like that here. So, okay. So it seems like we are going to have the tank picks going on right now.
Yeah. And obviously those tier ones are the scouts. F-Zero and Relic's doing a good job for their team, sort of getting into advantageous positions to locate burn all empires.
That's right. And they've been great here, and let's go ahead and bring this one up. So now looking here, we have no one picking tanks just yet. We're going to wait and see what's going on here. Of course, Steps will be the battleground for this game. Waiting to see what the picks are going to be for all of these players here. And guys, if you have any feedback, please feel free to let us know in the chat, you know, as usual. What is anyone talking about here? They're talking about your YOLO strats? I saw YOLO.
YOLO.
Yeah.
YOLO.
Please
know
YOLO.
YOLO.
Please know YOLO. I agree with that. Who was that? Give him love. That was Unreal BR. Yeah, we're not. No YOLO for you.
Okay.
It's awful. Why? YOLO is like a horrible
term. Banned.
You've been banned.
I like the cringy,
the cringeworthy YOLOs.
So it looks like almost all the tanks are locked in.
Yes, here we go. So there you can see Friction, as well as Absolute and Negatron. They're going to, and also, wow. So we have a bunch of AMX 1390s here. And here we go for Steps. So more open. I'm expecting a little bit more of artillery push. Let's see what the T1s are going to bring with the scouting. But I'm expecting a lot of craziness there with the with those pushes with the AMX 13s. That's going to be a great encounter. And, I also want to see what Revenant's going to do there with that WZ-132. That should be pretty fun.
Definitely. This is exciting.
Yeah.
I like learning this game.
I do too, actually. It's actually really fun to cast. And Perishing, by the way, Hugo Maximus is using a Perishing. So I'm curious to see how that's going to unfold. But look at here. You can see the battleground really open. Much different in comparison to Himmelsdorf, which is the map that we just saw. So let's go ahead here, and we're going to be following Azrael. No, let's go ahead and give some love here to Rill. Let's see what we're going to do for him.
All right, and it looks like...
look at that there.
Ooh, sneaky snake.
I got the lead strats. You don't even know about that. I saw the button. I'm like, this has to do something. Okay, so we do have identification here. It's going to be right here, right by C8. So let's go ahead and hop on board. That is going to be Revenant here using that WZ-132. He did manage to identify one. Let's see what he's going to be bringing to the table. He is going to find Absolute Royal. Having to drop back, trying to get the angle on him, but Royal's smarter than that. He's going to drop back. Hugo Maximus is actually going to be in an encounter right now, and that is not going to look good here. That will be a Jojack in that AMX 1390, who did manage to actually take a few shots there on Hugo.
Yeah, and it looks like while they were sort of occupied by looking at Royal behind that rock, Soviet and Negatron are pushing in from the left, trying to put shots on Jojack there, down to 80% health, as they sort of found all
of Burn,
yeah, all out in the open.
Oh man, and Revenant's actually going to be taking some shots. The encounter is about to begin here, and you can see here that Burn All Empires, they're going to be going right back over to their position. There's going to be so much encountering right here. Zone Delta, he's going to be at 56%, as well as Jojack sitting at 58%. Tanks are going to be converging on the positions. Great push there to force Burn to go back to their base. Fulcrum on the attack. I'm loving what I'm seeing here.
Hugo down to 53%, though, caught a little bit out in the open, is going to retreat behind Negatron and Absolute Royal. And I love the way Absolute Royal has been playing. He got out early into that rock position, poked out, said, "Hey guys, I'm over here, peekaboo," pulled back behind that rock that allowed Soviet to push up and begin this engagement.
Yeah, but Soviet's in a bad spot. He is not going to get taken out just yet. Soviet does manage to live to fight another day, as Jojack will be in a spot where he is going to sit at 34% health. And, of course, even more shots peppering him here.
Yeah, G-Forcer also low down to... Oh, and he is taken out by Hugo. Hugo going huge for his team right now.
Oh, no, and here he comes. Oh, with the ram, Jojack gets taken out by Negatron. And now it is going to be a 4v6. What a push there. Unfortunately, the scout's not able to do all that much. Trying to shoot some rounds forward here and hit him, but man, Rill's going to get dropped as well. And now looking at Hawk's perspective inside of the bushes, waiting to see, of course, trying to, you know, cook some donuts. Or we don't cook donuts in the thing, never mind.
Hugo Try Maximus living up to his
hot dogs.
Name, though. Oh, my gosh.
Yo, Hugo Maximus is just tearing it up with that perishing. He actually picked up 3 kills with that.
Yep.
And Zone Delta, he picked up 2 of his own. But, man, this has certainly been a great matchup here between these two teams. Zone Delta is going to get taken out. That's not going to look good here. Azrael and Hawk are going to be the last two. And Azrael's taking shots all around the corner here. Azrael is going to get dropped, and that's going to do it.
Hugo again.
As Fulcrum managed to take this game here, they are going to win this this next matchup, game number 3 here on Steps. Wow, yeah. Great run. That was intense.
I love the play there out of Fulcrum behind those rocks.
That was
an amazing push. So good at using that terrain to their advantage, and that's really where Burn All Empires sort of took the loss, is they just got caught out in the open.
Yeah, and then they had to double back, and you know, whenever you're on the back foot, doesn't matter what game you're playing, whenever you're on the back foot, you have a lot to work on there, and there's a lot to work with if you are Fulcrum, because you know, you have them running, their shots are going to be as accurate, obviously. There's just a lot to, you know, it was just a great rush there to end that one. And I was a little concerned because Steps, being a very massive map, I thought was going to, take a little while here. But it's just a flat land. It's like go after each other and, you know, shoot each other up. It was pretty cool.
Yeah, Fulcrum definitely recognizing that the aggressive style has been working out for him.
Yeah, that's right here. And it seems like you've been jumped over to the other side. So.
Oh, beautiful.
Okay. All right. So we're going to options. We're going to the markers. And we're going to turn on the health indicator. Booyakasha.
There we go.
Okay. I believe I changed the vehicle health to HP left. I believe I did that there, guys. And again, thank you so much for the
shout outs to chat.
Yeah, man.
And everyone watching.
You guys are amazing. It's awesome stuff there. Trying to look here. And I'm actually looking here at the just like what we have here for icons and whatnot. But anyway, so, you know, actually there's a lot of cool stuff here, guys. Of course, you know, again, we're learning, right? We're learning, you know, this is the first time I've ever done this before. So this is pretty cool stuff. Seems like we're going to be playing on mines here, which is a very hilly type of map here. And in the center of the map provides a perfect outpost for attack. So
yeah,
let's see how this unfolds for them.
And if Fulcrum's playstyle has indicated anything, I would assume that they would push down aggressively towards that main road.
Yeah.
Just because that seems to be what's working out for them.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, they've been showing that they are the aggressor here, without a doubt. And they are the ones that are dictating the pace of the game, which is something you always want to do no matter what the game is. You always want to control the pace. And it definitely seemed like Fulcrum had that in Steps. And they also had it in Himmelsdorf as well. So let's go ahead here and take a look as we have the tanks pick T69s here for Burn and a T62, T69s. There's going to be an OBJ 416 here and a T32 for G-Forcer. So it seems like those are going to be those Tier 8 tanks that they're going to be rolling with.
Yeah.
That's quite interesting there.
I'm looking for more plays out of Hugo, though. That's slowly becoming my dude.
Yeah, Hugo Maximus is your dude now. He's like, yeah. He's like your boy.
Yeah. It's like if I was a gladiator, I would want him like in the ring.
Name yourself.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Hugo Maximus entering the arena.
Just, yeah, it fits.
Hey, it really does. It really does. Okay, here we go. So, battle's going to start in 20 seconds. Interesting to see what they're going to do out the gate here. You can already tell the hills look for a lot of activity over here right by this mid area. Possibly some units moving in, trying to get some, trying to get vantage points.
Looks like they're pinging around the map there.
I think they're just pinging the ping.
Oh, okay. We'll see.
I would ping the ping. It's like the ogre talk. All right. All right, here we go. So rolling out here as we're going to go ahead and jump over to Revenant. As Revenant's going to be the one at the point position here, moving away really quick. He's going to be in that T69, making his way right through the farm. He's going to tear through his clothing. Oh, my God. The person's clothing is done. Okay. I just had to point that out.
And Fulcrum, actually, I don't want to say I called it, but I called it. They've actually pushed out just dead to the middle. They're all just in the middle with their two
Fulcrum
scouts.
Fulcrum is already in this position here. That is not going to look good. As it seems as if these guys are going to be encountering each other any second now.
That's right. Soviet and Hugo.
And look what they're trying to do here. Look
middle.
What they're doing. They're actually boosting each other up.
All right. It's the caterpillar strat.
Train boost.
Safety first, then teamwork.
Yeah,
that's,
right
that's
there.
That's the rules.
And
rules
we actually have a unit that is going to be moving in here, and I'm going to find out who that is. That will be G-Forcer, who's going to be coming up on one, and that will be Friction. G-Forcer does recognize that Friction's going to be in the area. Friction knows that G-Forcer is there as well. Friction is going to be in that T69 coming out, and G-Forcer going for the shot. He's not able to nail that one. G-Forcer having to drop back on this. As Soviet is going to creep around the corner as well as Friction and Hugo Maximus. Look out for Hugo Maximus there in that OBJ 416. He's going to put some shots out, missing that one. Shots exchange all over the place here. Zone is going to have to back up. G-Forcer, he's going to find Hugo hitting him there. That's going to be a big
here
hit.
Comes
taking
Soviet
a huge
around
chunk of damage.
Excellent awareness again by him to pull into position. Hugo backing down behind that lock. Soviet inching back as well. G-Forcer inching his way up. But just excellent cover provided by Soviet for Hugo. I love the teamwork out of these two as, Absolute Royal is pushing in for the flank on Revenant and Zone Delta. This might not end well for them.
Yeah, let's take a look here at Revenant and Zone Delta here. So you can see Absolute Royal actually is going to be above them. So I'm interested to see if Revenant's going to move around, but I doubt that he will. G-Forcer, of course, still going to be in this encounter. Two tanks in front of him. He's going to have to back up here. Look
here
at Hugo Maximus rushing in. He might go ahead and take out a couple here, but you're going to have Soviet 13% health remaining as it's going to be 68 for G-Forcer. G-Forcer not in a great spot. Caught between a crossfire, having to drop back on this, but instead he's going to go full frontal forward. Let's see if he can make something happen. G-Forcer getting in the face of Hugo Maximus, rushing him down, not able to do any damage with that. Then he's blocking the shot here to take out Friction. He's holding him off. Let's see if Friction can stay alive. G-Forcer moving in, trying to make something happen. Revenant's going to be right there as well, and you're going to see that Soviet is going to get taken out there. Shots exchange all over the place, and that was just pandemonium, Frank.
Yeah, Absolute Royal just kind of backing away now, just scared for his life. He's trying to position himself in a way that he can, you know, fend off G-Forcer and Zone Delta and get some shots in here, but he is really the last damage dealer left for this team.
Yeah, this is not a good look here for Absolute Royal. Of course, Relics, the scout, still going to be alive here. Let's actually go ahead and jump over to, this is actually going to be real.
Relic goes down.
Had some scout action there. Yeah. That's not really going to amount to much, but that's going to be the end of that
there
one.
There goes Royal taking out Zone Delta. Looks like he might be moving into position on Real, who's only 36% down. Absolute Royal again taking out Zone Delta there. Beautiful plays by him.
Good spacing,
too. Is he going to be able to do this?
I don't know, man. I've never... Well, okay, so he could win this. I mean, he's going up against two T1s, and those are basically like paperweights, so they're going to get shot, and they're going to die right away. But he does have to worry about G-Forcer in that T32. So let's see if Absolute Royal is going to be able to make something happen here. Of course, who is he going to be moving around? I mean, I don't know. It's going to be a tough one here.
Oh, looks like he found SBM Hawk, who is only at 5%. So Absolute Royal might do this.
Yeah, Absolute Royal is going to be moving in for the kill. But he's going to take a huge chunk of damage here. Moving in around the side, trying to take out Hawk. Hawk, 5% health remaining. He's getting in the shot. Can he make it happen? He misses the shot there. as Hawk is going to somehow manage to just stay alive on this. Of course, Hawk doing the best that he can to make a cap
G-force
happen.
G-Force are coming in now.
This isn't
He's
good.
Rolling out towards Royal. Is he going to be able to predict this push? If Royal can get into a better position and sort of anticipate where G-Forcer is coming from, he could catch him off guard and do some massive damage to the side of that tank, but is he going to be able to?
Yeah, I'm really looking at G-Force here to make moves happen. You can see he's going to be right behind that rock. I don't know if they've identified him just yet, but the cab on there he actually is. He's going to be running away on this
shot from G-Forcer here.
And he's going to see if he can get an angle here and get the long-range shot.
Possibly spotted Rill as well, hiding behind this building. Now he's faced with a decision. Does he go for the kill on the weaker tank and possibly get sideswiped from G-Forcer, or does he just slow play it and let them come to him?
Yeah, and you can see there just a lot of health left. 41, though, for the T1s.
Yeah. This is a tense moment.
This is, man. This is intense.
Looks like G-Forcer is moving in somewhat towards that right side on the map. Absolute Royal doing a good job of sensing those pushes. Looks like he's going to move
in on
Royal.
41, 41. He's going to be able to pick off one. Absolute Royal with the pick. Able to find one. Now it's going to be a 1v2, but Absolute Royal, he only has 287 health left. Let's go ahead and jump on board here with Hawk. They're going to be hanging out together here. Absolute Royal, he's going to have to make a decision. Go for the challenge. Is that going to be the case here?
Yeah.
I don't know, because they're going to be able to cap this one in just a couple of seconds. This could very well be GG. If they get this.
Right. Looks like he is just trying to poke around this rock. Absolute Royal now slowly inching his way up. Taking aim.
And that's it.
Taken out.
All right. There you have it. As Burn All Empires manages to take game number 4. And we're going to a game 5 in our first best of 5 here.
Yeah.
And wow, that was actually a pretty good battle there. I mean, I must say, like a... You know, got to give credit to G-Forcer, man. He did about 2,336 damage, if I can get that correct. So damage caused to enemy vehicles right there. He was the big winner in that game. He also got to give credit to Absolute Royal. Look at this stat here. 3,000 damage that he did to a combination of these all these tanks here. That is some pretty awesome stuff there by him.
Yeah, and I although he didn't come out on top, I absolutely love the play by him. Playing extremely smart, extremely patient. Couldn't get into position against G-Forcer to clean up that kill.
Yeah, he got 3 kills on that one. That was a good run for him. All right, so we're going to see what the next map is going to be in just a second here. But this is already heated up to be quite the matchup between these two teams. This is just the first best of 5, so they're
right.
going to be playing whoever wins 2 best of 5s basically is going to be the victor here and go and represent the United States in China for the World Cyber Games Global Finals.
And that's exciting stuff. We saw Sox is going to be moving on
for
to
Crossfire.
China, right, to represent for Crossfire. If you guys missed that, again, an amazing series. It'll probably, if you aren't into Crossfire, it'll probably get you into Crossfire. It went beyond the game.
You had to use the reference one time.
We had to use it at all times. Yeah, and it really did. It was amazing showing from both teams. And the sportsmanship, too, as well, was phenomenal, which is something I just love about these WCG events.
Oh, yeah, I think that's the main thing here. You know, it is about fun competition at the end of the day. What is going on in the chat on your end? What are people talking about?
Immediately, I see a lot of numbers. T25/2, they're saying it's like the worst. It's not so bad. They're debating.
Debating.
On their favorite tanks.
Favorite tanks.
My favorite tank.
Which one's yours?
Hugo Maximus.
Hugo Maximus tank. Whatever tank Hugo Maximus uses is the tank that Frank enjoys.
Yeah.
So guys, you know, of course, you can feel free to let us know how we're doing in the chat. Of course, we're having fun here casting World of Tanks. And if you want to get social with us on Twitter, you can contact myself at GoldenBoyFCW and at Frank the Show for this fine-looking gentleman right here.
Hit us up.
Yeah, we're always trying to learn and get feedback. This has been quite the experience here for myself because I've spectated World of Tanks a lot. I've actually seen the ESL matches that went on in Gamescom there for the War Gaming League. And that was really fun to watch. I was listening to Pansy cast, and I tweeted. I was like, I hope I could do half as good a job as Pansy does casting this game. Because it certainly, you know, she makes it very intense. So, you know, it certainly is really fun to watch, and it's also very different. I think that's the appealing thing about this game.
Yeah, definitely a unique pacing to the game.
Yeah.
You know, you sort of have your pushes in your traditional, like, FPS or third-person shooters, and there's some of that. But then once the action hits, it hits hard in World of Tanks.
It really does. So I'm trying to take a look here to see what we have. So... Yeah. Oh, there we go. HP left. There we go. I did it on the wrong section.
Ah.
I apologize with that one, guys.
Okay, so it should be all set.
I'm really sorry about that. Hopefully cool. You guys don't hate us.
There it goes.
All right, so it seems like we're going to get this one started here in just a second, and I didn't get to apply, but that's okay. But all right, so we have two perishings here, and all right, let me go ahead and actually bring this one up here, and just let me do this real fast for you guys. So, you know, I know you guys said you wanted that. Oh, it seems like we got it. So there we go. All
right, beautiful.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Change HP left. There we go. Apply. Okay. Let's get back to the game here, folks.
Thank you again, chat, for letting us know.
No, we're not going to exit the battle. We want to stay here. We want to get back to the action.
In it. Looks like Hugo is the only one running a Pershing for Fulcrum there. So it'll be interesting going up 2v1 for him. Possibly
didn't apply.
An attempt from Burn All Empires to sort of target him.
Yeah, well, I'm holding the alt right now to do this, so it's okay.
Okay.
So you guys can see the HP. I apologize. For some reason, I just hit apply and it didn't work out. I don't know why. But we'll get it adjusted in a little bit here. But here we go. So we already have the WZ 132 moving in aggressively here. And, let me see. Oh, sorry about that. So here we go. That's actually moving up right here. That is going to be a very quick push from these players. Let's see if they're able to make something happen here.
Right, and as we see, it looks like Negatron is sort of retreating from this engagement, trying to reposition himself back at the base. And who is that? Someone is caught in the middle of Fulcrum right now, chasing down what looks to be Relics. Yeah, so I believe that is Revan is going to be able to take out a scout here early on in the match. Yep, down goes Relics.
Yeah, that was just heavy there. As you can see, a large chunk of damage being taken out, 267 damage. Great shots here by the AMX 1390 right across from him. Careful here.
Yeah, it looks like Negatron has spotted Revenant down
in
this
mid-train
side. Revenant going to try to approach here, but he could be caught if Hugo Maximus behind him decides to push up. Looks like Revenant is going to try to chase down this kill as he has figured out, basically, that Negatron is all by himself out here.
Yeah, well, Revenant really aggressive, of course. He's going to be pushing up Revenant versus Negatron, but there could be a flank coming any second now. This encounter is going to happen. Let's see if it's going to be a case here. And it seems like they are going to back up.
Okay. Revenant doing a little backwards action.
Wait a minute.
Side straight. Revenant going.
Trying to make something happen.
Trying to position himself behind these boxcars there to get a better shot.
Yeah, and he's going to be pushing in. He's putting his back to him there. Or actually not putting his back, putting
Negatron,
the front.
But, you know, Friction is going to take down Jojack while this little ballet is going on over here.
Yeah, let's actually just see what's going on with every tank here. Oh, we actually have G-Forcer taking a huge chunk of damage as well. Let's go ahead and hop back on board here with Revenant, as Revenant and Negatron still dancing.
The 24-hour dance marathon.
Yeah. It's so intense, it never stops. He wants to get an angle. Look at the angle. He actually gets it there, but he misses the shot on Negatron. That's going to be a huge loss there. Currently going to be sitting at 340 health here, 33% total. And he wants to see if he can get this shot. He's not going to be in a good spot, though, because as you can clearly tell, sitting here at 802 health, Negatron, not looking great.
And there we go. Royal taking out G-Forcer, as it looks like Friction and Hugo Maximus are going to try and push in on Azrael and Zone Delta. And there goes Azrael down as Hugo Maximus assists in. Hugo, going to spot Zone Delta, is not in a position to fire on him, though, as Zone Delta approaches close. Oh, excellent gap shot there from Hugo to take down Rill, as Zone Delta is now getting caught and getting just bombarded by Friction, Hugo, and Soviet.
This is it here. It seems like that will do it. Fulcrum is going to take that game, and they're going to take that series total, thus netting themselves one victory in this best of five, or best of threes of best of fives. There's certainly a lot there. I mean, really, I don't think that Hawk's going to be able to do much. I mean, he's kind of just like chilling back. He's 1v6 right now.
Just
and
taking time to sort of think about his life. You know.
I mean, yeah, you know, this is the time where you think like, you know, did I make the
get
right
reflective
decision?
Yeah.
Should I really have gone? And there you have it. Hugo Maximus ending that one. Didn't even see where Hugo came from. But that's going to do it there. So there you have it. Fulcrum taking game number one here to end this game, to end this first best of five. And now we're going to go into a second best of five.
Yeah. And I think that was just Fulcrum sticking to their game plan. it seemed like a similar play style from game two and three out of them, where they're able to just rush position in the middle, hold it, and then push up and outflank Burn All Empires.
That's very true. It's very true. So, you know, I'm, of course, trying to take a look here to see. But, yeah, so we have that there. But, yeah, man, I mean, that was definitely a crazy engagement between these teams. That's going to do it for that game. We're going to see if we can go ahead and switch sides here to make something happen. But they are going to take a break. So they're going to take a brief break, and we're also going to take a break. So, Frank, I mean, any last thoughts going into this next series?
You know, I think Fulcrum is in the position to take it. If they can keep that same play style, Burn All Empires is going to have to adjust to those flanks. And I think that's what's going to make the difference.
All right. So we're going to see how all this unfolds. Guys, don't go anywhere. Plenty more World of Tanks action between Burn All Empires and Fulcrum. I'm Golden Boy. This is Frank Deschel. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. Hey everyone, how's it going? And welcome back. I was fixing my glasses because, you know, I'm a nerd like that. You know, got to make sure.
Good.
It's like, let's play some World of Tanks. No, so really excited here, guys. It's going to be the WCG North American Qualifiers. I'm Golden Boy. This is Frank the Show.
What's up, guys?
We currently have a great matchup here between Burn and Fulcrum Gaming. Fulcrum currently leading in this matchup here. They won the first series of the best of five, taking it all the way to a game five.
That's right.
And now we're going into the second series.
Yeah, and if Fulcrum takes this, they will be going on to China to represent the USA at WCG, which is pretty dang awesome.
Yeah, you get a free trip to China. I want to go to China. That'd be amazing.
Yeah.
I would like hop on that in a heartbeat. Are you kidding me?
Absolutely.
It's amazing.
That's
yes,
what she said. That
So we're switching over sides here. I'm going to be jumping on board with the gentleman over in Fulcrum, and then Frank's going to be looking at Burn. Of course, we're going to be looking at the POV of Fulcrum here to get things started. And it seems like they're in the tank pick phase right now.
That's right. And you get the privilege, I would call it, of watching Hugo Maximus, the biggest, baddest tank there ever was.
I knew that was going to happen. I knew you were going to mention something. I was actually going to say I'm with your best friend, Hugo Maximus, right now, commentating the action.
Excellent.
Okay, so, and of course, guys, if you have not had a chance yet to follow the broadcast, please do so. You can follow. We are going to go live tomorrow as well with even more action. I think we have, like, FIFA and StarCraft coming up.
That's right.
Somehow, I'm going to figure out how to commentate StarCraft. That's going to be fun. But, you know, and then of course, FIFA, which is like
you
a
just yell goal, I think, right?
Yeah. And it seems like the picking phase, what was that brand? We did not get that one. Okay, minute 30 seconds for them to pick their tanks is the signal that we got. So let's go ahead and jump into the action here and see them picking their tanks. Let's see. We got the T1s here being picked for real. I expect them to go and pick their T1s right away.
Yeah.
Kind of sticking with a similar strategy here. Lakeville is going to be the battleground. Look for no one to use this route. I mean, I assume no one's going to try and take this road.
I mean, Fulcrum's kind of a fan of that aggressive down-the-middle push. It was working out for him. It worked out for him last game, so... we'll see. I mean, maybe that's sort of the
The I could be completely wrong on this, of taking this road here. Probably
it
like
looks
everyone
like you're kind of stuck, quite literally between like a rock and a hard place, just based on the mini map
or a lake.
Yeah,
you know, between a rock and a lake.
Yeah,
right. That'd be if I, you know, I would.
Duke's
create
building a lake.
Huh?
Did you know that?
Duke.
We were driving around yesterday.
Oh man.
Yeah.
And we were driving around, and our driver told us, he was like, "Yeah, man, you know, we're crossing through the Duke campus." He's like, "Yeah, so, you know, Duke's building a lake." And I was like, what? How do you build a lake?
Yeah.
How does that even work? And apparently they're building it.
They didn't have enough lakes. So they're like, you know what? Yeah. We're going to take this into our own hands. Play the role of God a bit. There's a lake now. There's a lake where they're used
they're
to not
going
be
in with
one.
Buckets and throwing the water in there.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That's going to be pretty bad. So it seems like they haven't picked tanks just yet. Here we go. So AMX 5100, 1390. And 5100 IS3, well, we haven't seen this one yet. And on the other side here, keeping it pretty standard.
Yeah.
So they have about 20 seconds left here, but it seems like they have all picked their tanks.
That's right.
And I'm looking forward to seeing Hugo with that SI3, and it seems like I do need to jump. Let me see here. This is me, I'm assuming.
Yeah. So you are good.
Okay, I'm good.
You
I'm
are
good. I'm
golden.
Good. So I'm with Hugo Maximus. Great. I get to follow his creativity.
Yeah.
And he's quickly just become like our favorite player because of
name and play style, really.
Exactly.
The play style fits the name.
Yeah, super aggressive.
He embodies Hugo Maximus.
He embodies the name Hugo Maximus, the greatest there ever was in the battlefield.
That's correct.
All right, so this countdown is going to begin in a couple seconds here. And if I was a betting man, I would have to say that they're going to be rushing up on this mountainous terrain, perhaps. If maybe the T1s could make their way through, look for the roads. I wonder if they're going to converge inside of the town by any means. That
would lead to some killer action for sure.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd definitely like to see some engagements there because that second map we played on that sort of close quarters map was definitely very awesome with them ducking behind buildings and behind other tanks.
Yep. And here we go. So it seems as if I was right on that call. No one taking this road here, but we do have a couple units pushing up. That is going to be, we have Soviet as well as Friction, who we're taking a look here. Hugo Maximus and Royal's actually going to be pushing up very aggressive with this AMX 1390.
Yeah.
Trying to push up inside of the town here. He got here relatively quick.
Yeah, G-Forcer and it looks like Negatron are now having a little soiree in the mountain range here. Sort of spotting each other, trying to get a shot off. Haven't done any damage yet, though. But it looks like everyone is... Or at least four Burnall Empires is going into the town, and they will run into no one, quite literally, based on your mini-map.
Yeah, actually, if I was correct here, Nagatron, who, thank you so much, Frodan, for correcting me. I got to say Negatron.
Oh.
It's Nagatron.
Okay, I was thinking, like, you know, Transformers.
Like Megatron. For the negative version.
Or Negatron Cloak.
Yeah. You know, but it's Nagatron.
All right.
And so huge shout out to Frodan, by the way, good friend. So Nagatron, he actually is going to be the guy we're going to hop on board with here. And, of course, in that AMX 1390 super quick tank trying to make their way around. And I'm taking a look, and there's really no one inside of the base. Who's that, like, on the top of the map there for Burn?
So SBM Hawk is kind of just in this brush, and Friction and Soviet are just basically knocking on his front door, but I don't know if he knows it yet. Looks like F-Zero-X took some damage there. F-Zero-X taking down to 17 health, but as soon as SBM Hawk was caught, he just got lit up.
And here we go. So let's go and hop on board with Hugo Maximus in that IS-3. As he is going to see, we actually do see a couple players out there. Oh,
yeah, Zone Delta putting some big shots onto Absolute Royal, who was caught on the open in that center road. Definitely the trail of tears, proverbially, for him, as Zone Delta and Revenant are going to regroup and take their sights on Hugo Maximus, Friction, and Soviet.
Here we go. Hugo Maximus getting aggressive here with this IS-3, finding one player. He's actually going to put some shots out, but he's not going to be in a great spot. Taking a huge chunk of damage here, 361. He's going to lose 220 himself, having to back up. Able to nail one, but he's going to lose 240 again. He is going to have a teammate, Friction, moving in and trying to support him here. Friction making his way around. He's going to throw down some shots here. Able to take a huge chunk, 335 there, right on Zone Delta. Getting aggressive once again as the action's heating up here. And we're going to have Friction moving up just a bit closer to hit Revenant down and into the water.
Drink!
Gets him. Oh, he's going to move in himself. He can't make it happen. He is going to die on that one. We're going to leave his POV. But I cannot believe that Hugo Maximus managed to live with that one, 28 health remaining.
Yeah, and
that's hilarious.
And while all this happened, though, Azriel and Jojack managed to sneak into the enemy base, and they are capturing it right now. Take a look at those seconds. Just take a look at how close those are.
Yeah, this is actually to the wire. They
literally
need something
back and
to
forth.
Tip. And it seems as if you're a betting man, Fulcrum's going to win this base race here, and it's going to be moving 80, making its way past the 90 mark now, and they're going to be able to get the base capture. That's going to give it to Fulcrum to take the first game. Good cap by them. It was a base race, and they made it happen.
Yeah, definitely a smart play by Azriel and Jojack, but because, you know, Fulcrum had more tanks, they were able to rally back and accumulate those seconds faster and take game one of the second best of five.
Star of that game was Friction with two kills to his name, doing a huge chunk of damage there, 1,279 to be exact. On the other side, though, Zone Delta was quite the aggressor, able to do 1,254 of his own damage, and that is going to do it for game number one there on Lakeside. That certainly was very intense, or Lakeville, excuse me. That was very intense and very awesome to see that push whip the tank down into the soup, giving him the business. I love it. I love it.
Dunking
so
him
good.
In the bath, man.
Dumping him in the bath. Oh, man. Okay, so we're going to do another tank pick here in just a little bit. But GG's to both teams on that one. Fulcrum coming out on top once again. Guys, if you're just joining us, this is currently the WCG North American Qualifier Finals, where the winner will move on to represent the United States and China. We have Fulcrum Gaming as well as Burnall Empires. I'm Golden Boy. This is Frank DeShow. We're going to get this one kicked off in just a little bit. I believe they started the timer, and they are going to be picking their tanks.
Yep, so they've started picking their tanks. G-Forcer opting to go with that AMX 1390, sort of the utility of what I've noticed, sort of like a defensive tank.
Very quick, but also very aggressive as well. Can take a good chunk of damage if it gets into a good position, for sure. And I guess I haven't picked a map just yet, so we're going to wait and see if they pick a map. But and it is going to be Mines here, which is actually a map that we did manage to take a look at here. A very hilly map, of course, and the center provides some great cover. But it kind of seemed like in this one, if I'm remembering correctly, this was Fulcrum just aggressively pushing. Yep. So now we have our two-minute timer going on. They are going to be picking their tanks. Let's hop into the action and check this out.
Yeah, so out of Fulcrum on this map, what we saw was they just rushed the middle and got into good positions and basically just outplayed Burnall Empires. So what Burnall Empires is going to need to do is expect that. and see if they can adjust. Because it works so well for Fulcrum, I don't really expect them to go too far away from that strategy.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, Burnall Empires, so the way that they've been losing a lot of these games has just been by just the sheer aggression of Fulcrum. That has been something that's really been benefiting them. But you always have to wonder, is that going to pan out for you in the long run? I want to know what's going on in the chat. What are they talking about here?
They're talking about the map. They said it's not to put you on blast, but they said it's not too hilly. There's a couple main hills.
Okay, so they pretty much just put me on blast. It's fine. Yeah. No, I mean, the disrespect is real. It's okay. I'm kidding, guys. I'm kidding.
But yeah, no, we appreciate learning alongside with you guys. And anything you can point out.
Here, a high hill in the center of the map provides a perfect outpost for your attack. So I guess I just read high hill and just said hilly.
Right.
All right. I'm sorry, guys.
That's all good.
Well, I tell you right now, man, after this, I'm definitely going to be heading home and playing some World of
Tanks. Yeah, I was hopping on plane a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
It's addicting. I'm horrifically bad. Tragically bad, actually.
My friend Haywood, I don't know if you know Haywood.
Yeah,
he's like addicted to this game.
Okay.
Like absolutely addicted. He just plays it nonstop. And you can actually see tanks are now going to be picked here. And we're going to have that perishing for Hugo Maximus. He's done damage with that tank.
Yeah. Azriel going to try and answer with that AMX 5100. See if that works out for him. Again, Hugo just playing so well as that bruiser. Just able to go in and do damage. And excellent like poking out as well. Which I like from him.
Yeah. And, you know, so let's see here. We have the choices have been all pretty much all out there for them. So that's going to be a good win. So that's going to do it there for the choosing phase. And let's go ahead and jump into the action. So not the hilly map. That's right. You know, I apologize. The one hill, which is located right over yonder. So we'll see who's going to get there first. Maybe those AMX 13s, 1390s might actually push in there.
Yeah, we'll see how they push out, of course. Burnall Empire is going to have to see if they can adjust, though. You know, they might know what to expect, but then Fulcrum can always throw them the curveball and say, hey, you know, we went all middle last time. Now we're not going to do that again. So it'll be interesting to see how this plays.
Yeah, that's right. And off the break here, it seems as if Burn's going to be moving out, sweeping over here to the left and trying to make their way over. While, of course, you can see Fulcrum, they're going to be going straight aggressive up in here with Nagatron leading the charge here with that AMX 1390. Again, the very versatile tank that we were talking about just a little while ago, making their way right to the mid here, seeing if they can get this cover inside of this this midtown. So they're moving right into town.
Yeah, and Jojack and G-Forcer moving out for Burnall Empires onto these islands on the left. They might spot the scout who is located just dead center of this island. But Burnall Empires going for a very spread out defensive-like play here as we see an engagement now occurring in the middle.
Here we go. We're going to have an engagement right now as Hawk is going to be in a bad spot here. The scout, you can see him right here. If Maximus is able to get an angle on him, he could take him out. He is going to get spotted, though. It seems like that's what that is. So there was just like a mass spotting there and lots of shots going down as Azriel is going to be in a bad spot. And it seems like Azriel is going to be going up against these AMX 1390s here, Absolute Royal and Nagatron. Azriel dropping back. He's going to have 902 health left.
Right.
Big shot there. That was going to come from Absolute Royal to take out one. Huge win for him. Going to take out the T1s there, so the scouts are going to be dead at this point in time.
Yeah.
Azriel, 425, 153, just getting pegged with shots.
Oof.
Absolute Royal able to close that one out and get the kill. Big win for him.
Yeah, and I really like that play out of Fulcrum. Absolute Royal pushing into the enemy base, and then basically Burnall Empires had this defensive strategy set up, and they were pushed out, had good map control. Fulcrum says, no, we're in your base now, and forced all of them to come back, and they just picked them off one by one.
Yeah, and now Soviet, he's getting aggressive, taking a huge chunk of damage here, 242 to be exact. He's sitting lovely with about 1,000 health there, 407 left for Revenant as Soviet. He's going to drop back and not get too aggressive there. The damage has already been done. Let's go ahead and hop on board here with Hugo Maximus, who's been the player we've always been talking about. Friction, he's going to be taking a seat. He's done. And Soviet's going to be actually engaging in, trying to make something happen, coming around the corner. Here she comes. Can he get the shots down and able to take him out? That was going to be a huge win there as they take down Revenant. But Zone Delta takes out F-Zero. That's going to do it there for their scout. They still have Relics left alive. Who's going to be in encounter trying to run away from this one? Jojack pushing aggressively, taking 30 damage from him, going in for the shot. Can this do it here? Do what you can. And that's going to close that one out as Relics will have to take a seat. Jojack, huge win for him. they're going to kill them. Actually, not that big of a win when you think about it. The scouts don't do that much damage.
Right. Jojack able to take out Relics there, but he's in a bad spot. Getting pushed up by Nagatron now. And Jojack trying to provide some support fire here, but he is just way, way out on that island.
Yeah, they're kind of pinned in here. They have Nagatron actually advancing forward on this position, so they are going to find him eventually. Let's actually jump here with Absolute Royal, who is currently sitting at 2% HP, 15 to be exact.
Yeah, Jojack and Hugo now spotting each other. Looks like Hugo's going to push in, but he does not have the health lead there, sitting at 223 health, while Jojack is retreating with 454. If I was in Jojack's position, I don't know what the answer is, to be honest.
I don't know, man. It's hard to say because really, like, you know, Hugo Maximus, his left track is a little bit damaged there, so he has to be cautious about that, too.
Looks like he's just going to go for the base capture, but, I mean, Fulcrum has more tanks, so they're going to be able to take this.
Yep. Here goes base capture now, and that is pretty much going to do it there.
Yeah.
They managed to make their way across. That will close out that game. Fulcrum is going to take this one in a landslide lead there, as you can see with that base cap. That will do it. Fulcrum taking game number two in this second best of five. One more, and they're going to go on to represent the United States at the World Cyber Games Global Finals in China.
Yeah. So, I mean, Burnall Empires did a smart job there of trying to counter that heavy push from Fulcrum.
Yeah.
But Fulcrum just sort of outstratted him again and sort of said, all right, that's what we predict you'll do.
Yeah.
And was able to capitalize on that.
Big winners here, Nagatron and Absolute Royal really being those bruisers doing a lot of damage. Nagatron, two kills to his name there with 1,200 damage. But look here, Hugo Maximus really, really helping out his team with 1,900 damage. 1,959, that is going to be a great number there for him. So that was the damage caused to enemy vehicles, of course. Jojack did a great job, but unfortunately it was not enough. Let's actually, I didn't know you could do that. Nice. Okay, so here we go. We're learning, guys. We're learning.
Look at all them numbers.
Hits received. Beautiful. Actually only took 4 hits, so that's pretty cool stuff. Look at them numbers. Okay, so there you have it. That was going to be game number 2 in the second best of 5 here.
Yeah.
If they take this one, that's it. We're done.
That's it. They're going to China.
So
represent
China.
Yeah, man.
I don't even know like how to
they're going
how to
beyond
like,
the game
for that.
All the way to China.
They're going to go beyond the United States that game to the even beyonder of the game in China. And so that was a great, great encounter. Now we're going to be going to Himmelsdorf. Oh,
I like it.
Boy, this
I like
is
it.
Ooh, I like man. So if we go to Himmelsdorf here, Fulcrum, this is pretty much when Fulcrum started to dominate.
Yeah.
They had that all push right down the mid. They were able to make some noise there, and it seemed like Burn was not able to make anything happen
right
on that push.
Well, and not only that, Fulcrum was kind of behind and out of position, and they were able to regroup in the middle as well with some great recovery from Absolute Royal zooming in and absorbing some damage. Same out of Soviet. So I think this is a map where their sort of teamwork really takes center stage, and they're able to capitalize on that a lot.
All right, so here goes the 2-minute picks now. The 2-minute time for the picks of the tanks. Of course, the T1s, they're going to be picked right away. We already knew that. But Himmelsdorf, man, this is a map that I like watching.
If there was
quick.
an exciting game, I would like it to be played on this map.
Yeah, I agree. So what's going on in the chat? What's everyone talking about in there, man?
Kind of discussing tanks a little bit. Some USA chants, excellent there. Obviously got to have some love.
Love for the country, man.
Absolutely. Which is great, and I urge all of you to go on and watch, you know, the WCG in China.
Yeah, and also watch that War Gaming League, the War Gaming League stuff as well, if you guys aren't already. That's some great stuff there, man. Like, I got to give it to them. I love the production that they have going on, and I'm definitely going to be tuning in a lot more.
Right.
Now that I've kind of gotten a taste of this here, the action's very fast and mm-hmm. frantic, which is fun.
And for those wondering, of course, what we've got coming up, we finished up Crossfire yesterday with Sox going on to USA to represent us.
Yes.
And then we've got Street Fighter later today.
Yes.
And tomorrow we will have FIFA and StarCraft 2.
Yeah, FIFA. That's great. So me and Frank have a history of casting sports games together.
Mm-hmm.
We did NHL.
Yeah.
And, of course, none of us – well, I never played hockey. I mean, that's just not something that a Puerto Rican kid in the Bronx does. I mean, just being honest, like,
right,
we just don't play hockey, you know. But, like, it was really fun and entertaining to check out. So I'm really looking forward to seeing FIFA tomorrow. Here goes the picks going down. G-Forcer taking that IS-3. But two IS-3s here for Friction and Hugo. They're going to be the aggressors here, doing a large chunk of damage. Look for, let me see, Absolute to do some work here, along with Nagatron with those AMX 5100s. They're going to be those the engagers, if you will.
Definitely
from what
looks
we've
like
been
an aggressive lineup out of Fulcrum there. Just looking to close it out, I think.
Yeah, yeah. Fulcrum, they want to shut this one down as quickly as they possibly can. So here we go. I mean, if you're betting man, I mean, hey, who do you guys in the chat want? Do you want Fulcrum or... This is my tank right here, just so you guys know. This is my tank.
I like it.
Yeah, I do damage with this vehicle right here. I just ram everyone.
Yeah.
I die usually.
You, like, deliver orange slices to, like, the rest of the guys, like, keeping them hydrated.
Yeah, right.
You're the team, like, the
lemonade.
Team member. Yeah.
Lemonade. Okay. Here we go. So, yeah, who you guys in the chat want to see take this one? Fulcrum to represent the United States or burn all empires? Let us know in the chat. And here we go. Kicking off the action. We're going to be taking a look here at Frank's favorite person.
Let's go.
Hugo Maximus in the IS-3.
All right. So out of Burn All Empires here, they are opting to sort of split off to the right and left. But it looks like Revenant is going to opt to hang back and sort of guard this middle area right in front of their base. Because as Fulcrum has conditioned them to do, they've been known to rush their base and sort of just go for those base captures to pull them out of position. So a nice adjustment there out of Burn All Empires.
Yeah, but you know what, though? On the other side here with Fulcrum, they are pushing all on the left side of the map, and they did manage to identify a player. The encounter could be happening any second now with Friction leading the charge here in this IS-3. They're able to find one of the scouts. That's going to be Hawk there, SBM Hawk, and he's not going to be in a good spot because, of course, he will scout them, but the question is, is it going to matter? They're so spread out here.
Yeah, and this is actually playing out extremely similar to that game, too, in the first series. Fulcrum did rush the same street, and it looks like, they're both pushing in almost in the exact same way with Friction and Hugo there.
Yep, and let's go ahead, hop on board here with Hugo Maximus, as Hawk is going to have to double back on that position, not get too risky here. But G-Forcer is actually going to encounter Hugo.
Nice
and
shots
take
on Hugo.
Big hit on Hugo, man. Did not expect that at all.
Yeah, chunking him out. Maybe catching him off guard a bit there. But it looks like a couple members for Fulcrum are pushed up into the base as well. So they might pull back.
All right, well, we'll come back to Hugo in just a bit here. But there's a lot going on. Unfortunately, Relics, he is going to get taken out. So that's going to be one of their T1s getting dropped right away. And look here, you're actually going to see Hawk. He's going to get dropped as well. And that is going to be Absolute Royal moving in there with that one. He is going to be able to get that kill. So that's going to net him one. Hitting G-Forcer there for a huge chunk of damage here. As you saw, Hugo Maximus engaging as well and hitting G-Forcer for almost 1,000 of combined damage there between these two teams. Are these two players, and that's
G-Forcer
gonna do it for
G-Forcer. Goes down. Zone Delta taking big hits as well as Azrael, and it looks like Revenant are trying to come in and get a flank on Hugo and Soviet, but I just don't know if they're in a good position to do so. Oh, and there goes Hugo. Nice shots by Azrael and Soviet. We're gonna get taken down as well, it looks like.
Jojack actually cleaning house here. Nagatron's going to be in a bad spot. He's going to have to drop back here. Shots going to be exchanged. It's all going to be tied up as far as player counts are concerned. Absolute Royal's going to be coming around for the flank here. Let's see if he's able to make something happen. Absolute Royal, he's going to the mid portion of the map. Friction, he's going to be over here by himself in this IS-3. And now it is going to be a 3v4. And just as we thought Fulcrum was going to be able to make something happen, the tides have turned just like that. F-Zero, he's going to be stuck in this position here, trying to make something happen, but
he
is going to get taken out. No cap for you, says Revenant, as he closes that one out, thus leaving Friction and Royal to be by themselves in a 2v4.
Yeah, and, interesting play there. Real was going for that base capture on Fulcrum, but he opted to pull back and regroup on his base, as he is going to get spotted by Absolute Royal, and is now just sort of, on his toes. I'm probably terrified, the little tank that could, trying to get away right now.
Yeah.
And a good play out of both Revenant and Jojack. They were sort of on their way to capture the base and pulled back and made excellent flanks on Hugo and Soviet there. And now it looks like they're just repositioning themselves for the next engagement.
Yeah, and now just as you saw there, as Real does get taken out, and shots are going to be exchanged here. Absolute Royal's not going to be in a great spot. Azrael's going to take a huge chunk of damage. He damages their gun too, so that is going to hurt Absolute Royal just a bit. He's going to have to play this one slow. Friction, let's go ahead and hop on board with him.
All right, taking a look now. Azrael at full health. Friction sitting behind this building. Looks like Revenant, Jojack, and Azrael might try to push in. And he's just sitting there, just hanging out in the middle.
Can they make this clutch happen? I don't know, man. This seems like a little bit harder in World of Tanks to be able to make a comeback happen. I mean, you can do it with some great coordination, but it's going to take some great coordination and really taking someone off guard. I mean, when I say great coordination, I'm talking great coordination.
Yeah.
And I don't know if they could do this here.
So a bit of a stalemate. Everyone just waiting for the other team to make a move.
Oh, and wait a minute, we do have an encounter here as Friction's going to be moving in, getting in this gunfight here, trying to make something happen as Friction is going to take a hit there, but he is also going to deliver some damage to Revenant, or Revan, sorry about that. Friction behind this building, Revan as well. He is going to have Absolute Royal in the back to give him some kind of support there. Revan's going to take another hit, 352 damage remaining for him.
Azrael moves in to provide some support for Revan as he takes down that telephone pole there. Azrael trying to get shots on Friction behind this wall, but just is not in a good position to do so. Also doesn't want to overextend and take any unnecessary damage. As we see him swooping around there, trying to outstrafe Friction.
Oh,
Absolute Royal getting caught in the crossfire. Revenant
catches
him in between. Oh!
Able to nail one there. He has to get away from this one, and it seems like Azrael did not have his sights on him. Now it's going to be a one-on-two here with Jojack going up against Jojack and Azrael going up against Friction. And
Jojack
wow,
is very weak, so he's got to play sort of passive here and maybe just serve as sort of a distraction or position himself to get a long-range snipe off because, you know, 14 health, you breathe on and he's dead.
Big hit there by Friction as he nails one on Azrael, who did not expect that one coming at all. Great angle from Friction. That was a shot right there. Going on the hill, finding him right at the corner and nailing him on that one. Azrael took a big hit there.
Yeah. So it looks like Azrael is going to pull back towards Jojack, and they're going to go with a little strength and number strategy as Friction is sitting pretty comfortably at 900 health. But Azrael now on the prowl, trying to outflank and flank around towards this middle street. And right now it's just sort of a war of positioning. Each one trying to get the best advantage.
Look here, but Friction's going to encounter here Azrael in a 1v1. As Friction's going to do his best to stay alive here. They're going to be pushing on forward. Friction is not going to be in a good spot here. 600 damage remaining. Friction trying to make something happen. Here comes Jojack for the cleanup. Can they make this one happen? 265, and that will do it. Finally, we're seeing some life out of Burn to take this game and end that matchup there. Did not expect Himmelsdorf going that way in the favor of Burn, for sure.
An excellent job by Burn All Empires, keeping their tournament life alive there.
Yeah.
Fighting back hard.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, great run there by Burn. You got to give credit to Jojack and Azrael. Azrael did get caught off guard a couple of times there, but I think the big encounter was when I believe that was Friction moved in there with Revan, and they just – or actually, no, it was when Revan, Friction, as well as I believe Absolute Royal, they got caught in that encounter there near the building, and Absolute Royal just got – devastated, just crushed right away. That really did hurt Friction there, but they did not expect that push at all. That was great, though.
Yeah, and Absolute Royal has kind of been that playmaker where he gets into these great positions, you know, behind rocks, behind buildings, and sort of just serves as bait and then flanks around. And if you take him out early, they can't sort of execute and capitalize on that game plan, which I think affected them there.
Yeah, it certainly did. So, guys, we're going to take a brief break, I believe, or maybe take like a 1 minute break, and then when we come back, we're going to have the continuation of this matchup. Currently 2-1 in the series count. All the guys in Fulcrum need to do is just win one more. They're going to go and represent the United States and China. But can Burn All Empires answer back?
We shall see in a minute. Right. Stay tuned. All right, guys, so we are back. The teams are picking their tanks as the two-minute countdown has begun. 40 seconds left now for the teams to pick their tanks. So we'll see what they lock in a minute here. Will Fulcrum be able to take this game and move on? We shall see.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and give this one a pronunciation test. Prokhorovka.
All right.
I got it.
I'll take it.
I nailed it. I feel confident. Okay, so here we go. This map, of course, open terrain, as you guys see there in the description.
Right.
Featuring a large hill and a railway embankment. So that should be an interesting place to see an encounter here. This is the railway here, as you can see. But this seems to be the hill area. So let's see how this encounter works out. Of course, the picks have gone. Hugo Maximus going with that perishing. And we have four AMX 1390s here.
Okay.
Okay, interesting strategy
here
out of Burn.
Yeah, definitely going to be interesting to see how this plays out for Burn All Empires. They proved in the last game that they can hang with Fulcrum and outpace them in this match. So let's see if they can do it again here on this map.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, of course, guys, just so you know, Fulcrum only needs one more victory, and they will move on to China, represent the United States in the
awesome.
World Cyber Games. That's right.
So good.
So they only need this victory here to make it happen, but Burn definitely trying something a little bit different, while Fulcrum kind of running with a more, I guess you could say, a similar or a lighter strategy, not trying to get too crazy with their options here. They went with two AMX 1390s and two T69s, while we have four AMX 1390s on the other side for Burn, so definitely a very interesting tank comp here.
Yeah, so Zone Delta and Revant, actually all their AMX 1390s, sort of pushing together over these tracks towards the right side of the map and moving up.
So they're going to miss.
Yeah.
They're going to miss these guys, because on the other side here, you have Fulcrum. They're going to push on forward from their spawn, moving down, as you guys can see right here. And this is the position, actually, where Burn is currently located. So
looks like both teams want to try to use that railroad track as sort of a line of sight blocker and just section off the map that way, as it will provide a lot more safety towards either side of the map. So smart play out of both teams, makes a lot of sense, but I think the difference here we might see is going to be made by the tank compositions.
That's right there. One tank actually was spotted. And who is that there in the mid tracks?
Yeah, so we have, let's get a view on him. We have G-Forcer here in the T-32, sitting mid-train, just right in the center, holding down the middle, playing that power position, trying to see if anyone's moving up from Fulcrum, but it looks like they're opting to go just down that road on the left side of the map and perhaps move into this enemy base.
Yeah, that's right, and actually there is going to be an encounter right away here as F-Zero. He is going to find another T-1 here. That's going to be Rill. And, of course, this could be a pretty cool battle here between these two. I don't know if either one's going to engage, and I don't know if F-Zero knows that he's there. Surely he has to if he just looks up here, but I will assume he does know that he's there because he is popping up there on the map.
Yeah, and so it looks like Revant is moving in towards F-Zero-X to take out the scout. Good communication, I'm sure, from Rill as he moves across these tracks. Looking like he might be playing a little patient, doesn't want to jump over those tracks into an ambush or anything like that. But what he doesn't know, of course, is that Fulcrum is totally located on the bottom left sectors of this map.
That's right. You can see F-Zero is trying to keep this one, scout them here so they know that he's going to be there. But, of course, he didn't know that Revan was trying to move in there for that kill. He does have, this player Rill spotted, but Revan was right over here. And then on the map, G-Force, he got spotted as well. No encounter just yet, as the base is going to be ripe for the picking. No, that actually is going to be two players here in the base, right in these sectors located in this area. There you can actually see one was spotted. That was going to be coming from more than likely Relics with that spot. Yes, he does locate one.
Yeah, and G-Forcer looks like he has his sights set on Nagatron, but is in a little bit of a pickle here, as I think Burn All Empires is actually aware of Fulcrum's position in that center left of the map. And there we see Revan finally getting that kill on F-Zero-X, able to take out that scout there, while G-Forcer is now being engaged by Soviet and Hugo Maximus in the middle.
Yeah, that's right, Hugo Maximus, he's going to be lingering right outside here, trying to see if he can find anyone to creep up. No one getting aggressive just yet. Lots of activity going down in the side of Burn, though, as they're all hanging out inside of the tracks in this location right here. So you're going to see a lot of activity here, and Hugo Maximus needs to be able to at least spot one to make something happen. Losing that T1, though, not the biggest loss, although that did give them that opportunity to identify if anyone was coming through the flank. So they did take that guy out. And that means that there's going to be two tanks actually up there. And that's going to be Rill as well as Revan. They're going to be located near the Fulcrum base. So we'll see how all this unfolds.
Yeah, I think they are just waiting to maybe make a move into the base. But it looks like Revan is going to come back and regroup with G-Forcer in the middle. This might be the benefit of running all those AMXs. They are able to cover a lot of terrain very quickly and reposition themselves in advance and in response to Fulcrum.
Yeah, I mean, that is actually a great observation there, Frank, because, you know, those AMXs, you have to wonder, like, running four at the same time, that is really weird for us at least.
Right.
But I'm pretty sure, you know, a lot of people watching this one are like, that actually was a pretty good strategy there.
Right.
I wonder why Fulcrum didn't do it. So, you know, of course, guys, you know, this is all stuff that is speculative on our part here, but feel free to sound off in the chat. Let us know what you think.
Yeah.
G-Forcer there, he is going to still be identified by Hugo, so he's not going to be able to really move anywhere.
Right.
And they do have Rill, who is still hanging out by the base.
And what they could do is have Rill attempt to go for this cap and try to just at least pull Fulcrum out of position and reveal their location, because right now we are just seeing a big stalemate, a big waiting game, as all these AMXs are just waiting to respond, essentially, for a location flank in.
Yeah, and it seems like they did manage to identify one player in the middle there. Besides G-Force, there is another player that's hanging out. There's another one right next to him. Who is that?
That's right. Let me try and get to him so we can find out who is G-Force's battle buddy. There's Jojack.
Jojack.
He might have spotted Absolute Royal moving across the middle. Hugo Maximus looks like he and G-Force are just sort of exchanging, you know, warning shots right now, trying to get one of them to make a move. That I think the problem that Fulcrum might run into is if they move up to engage G-Forcer here in the middle, all those AMXs are going to be swarming on that location.
Yeah, that's the part that I guess I'm a little cautious about here, of course, because, you know, obviously one has to wonder that, like, the ground that the AMXs cover really is alarming, but seems like there is some activity going on in sector A6, that's going to be right here. And, oh, there is going to be enemy movement here that will be zoned. So, zone there in that AMX 90. He's trying to get risky, moving on a position here to make something happen. Take a look right now over at Friction, who is in that T69 alongside Soviet battle buddies together, hanging out.
Chilling. Getting it done.
Like villains.
All right, looks like Revenant has not moved a lot from the bottom position near this base towards the tracks. And, you know, they're. Burn All Empires, I guess you'd call it getting a little more aggressive because they're sitting on top of the tracks now instead of behind it, but really not a whole lot of action going down from either side.
Yep, and Nagatron as well as Relics, they're going to be over here in this position as you guys can see on the map. That's Nagatron and this is Relics. As you see it hiding up, highlighting on the map, they did identify G-Force once again.
Right.
Friction trying to see if he can get an angle on him. He sees him, but he's right behind those tracks, so they're not able to get a clean shot on him. Good coverage there and a good plan. Time is going to be winding down as we're going to cross that three-minute mark, so the pressure is certainly on both of these teams to make a move.
That's right, and, you know, I'm not sure how this is going to go down for Burn All Empires. They have Jojack and, you know, Revenant sitting on either side of G-Forcer on top of these tracks with AMX 1390s, perhaps trying to lure them into one of them, thinking they're alone, and have G-Forcer respond, but...
Who's that pushing up there, right, in Sector 5, G5?
So it looks like Zone Delta is sort of on the move. Can see Hugo Maximus behind him, and he's just sort of roaming this bottom left area of the map looking for anyone, but in response, Fulcrum has started moving back up towards the top left sectors there.
Okay, and you can see here that in this perishing, Hugo Maximus trying to get a pick. Time's going to be winding down. We're down to 2 minutes and 15 seconds here.
Yeah, guess what I'm going to say again. AMX. Maybe this is a strategy too. Stalemate it out and then just swarm the map with, you know, a lot of time left. They're going to be able to respond to a lot more area and cover more ground, you know, if Fulcrum isn't running as speedy of a unit comp.
That's very true. So let's see what's going to happen here. Who's going to make the move? Who's going to make something happen? It seems like they do have a unit trying to push on forward.
Yeah.
Inside of the cap point here, they're going to go super aggressive to the capture, and it seems like it could be a read here from Absolute Royal. No, never mind. They're going to drop back. They're not
gonna
going to move that way.
All the AMX 90s for Burn All Empires are now just rushing to the top middle of the map, right around Sector A6. And it looks like they might go for this base. You've got Zone Delta, Revan, and Azreal all pushing in, being hesitant when they reach the top of these tracks, as they should, because they are unaware of Fulcrum's position right now.
Yeah, that's right. No one is going to be in the spot here to make anything happen. Nagatron's going to be the only one inside of this, and he's going to identify anyone coming around the meadows here and making their way right through the field to get inside of the cap point. And you can actually see here that they're now deciding to drop back and make something happen. But I think it might be too late here, as we have four units pushing in. Here we go. Nagatron not identifying one that's going to be clearly right in front of that cap point. There's going to be Revan. Nagatron does manage to see him here. And Nagatron able to nail one shot. A huge shot there on Revan. Able to take
all
him out for another
AMXs,
one. 244.
Yep, have moved up, but they're taking damage. Revan taking heavy
fire. Look at this
here. Down to 310.
Oh, no. And Revan is actually going to be able to. Let's see. No friction closes that one out. Now they're going to get aggressive and push in here. Absolute Royal's going to have to drop back. Those AMXs really coming in handy, as you can see. Let's go ahead and jump on board here with Soviet, who manages to put in a shot there. Make something happen.
Yeah, and Fulcrum just has to make
Revan's
a move.
Be
Soviet,
done.
Hugo, and Friction, you see they're just hanging out in the middle, grouping up. And the same with these AMXs now. And I don't think that's the play they want to make. Looks like Fulcrum has a little more firepower in this collection, so they could get picked off very easily if they do not play it smart
that's
in this
it.
Engagement.
And we have a tie. Draw game here in this matchup. Fulcrum does not get risky
no
with it.
No moves made.
And Burn, I, you know, let's actually defer to the chat here and see what they feel about that play.
Draw.
What was the situation? Why didn't Burn go in and cap with those AMXs? Why didn't they do that? I'm curious. I'm wondering why.
It's a really odd play. I would have to assume that they thought that Fulcrum was going to do the same thing. And they being in position with those AMXs, I would think that they could respond quicker, so they thought that they could basically out-hustle them and catch them off guard. But they assumed wrong, and Fulcrum was just still holding down that middle area, and, you know, with the weaker force out of the AMXs, I'm guessing.
Yeah, yeah.
It
I
didn't
mean,
work out for them.
Yeah, I'm really, you know, puzzled on that one there. I'm trying to see what the chat is saying here. No gluts, no glory. They never got a good spot. Don't know where the other team was. Drag it out too long. Very true. So that was something that I did notice, right? The other team did not, like, really see. Like, they only saw G-Force. And G-Force was there. Like, he was hanging out.
Right.
And he wasn't moving. And then the other team, they couldn't identify where it was either. And then when they thought that they cleared up the top for them to be able to move in, then you had, you know, Nagatron, who was there waiting and was able to plug that hole. So then they kind of dropped back, and they're like, okay, we don't know how many are actually here. Let's drop back here, because this is it, right? Like, if we throw this one, then we're done. So again, they didn't spot them. So because of that, they didn't get that good angle to make, or a good attempt to make their way inside of the base to begin the base cap. That was it. We got a draw, and I guess we're going to go ahead and begin this one again. That was pretty good.
Yeah, that was definitely an interesting examination. So they're going to replay.
Yes.
Replay the map because of the draw.
Brent, our producer in the back, Captain Obvious, telling us they're going to replay it because it was a draw.
I'm letting you guys know.
I'm just messing with him. But he's so business. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and jump right back into the action here. Orovka is going to be the battleground here in that draw that had happened here. The series count's currently going to be 2-1. Fulcrum leading, and if they win this game, if Fulcrum manages to take this, they will be the U.S. representatives going to China to compete at the World Cyber Games Global Championship. That should be pretty fun here. And running with that same tank comp here, I'm assuming they can't change it.
Right, so they're locked in.
Here we go. Okay.
So each team has kind of showed their hand now, you know?
Yeah. I'm assuming this one to go a little bit quicker, I think. I don't know. Something tells me that they're going to encounter each other very, very fast.
Right. Yeah. Cool. I hope so.
Let's see where the breakoffs
I like
where
seeing
the
stuff get
happen.
Blown up, man.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's tanks, man. You can't get mad about tanks.
No.
You know?
You can't do it. I tried once. I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
I almost got arrested. They're like, you can't do that. You can't get mad about tanks. I was like, well, that's the rules.
Move out. Oh, actually, my friend Haywood there, big shout out to him. He's a World of Tanks competitor.
Okay.
And he told me a fun fact that both of these teams had to play from their hotel/cafes last night because they had WGL NA matches.
Oh.
Yeah, so I don't know what the results were, but we'll find out, you know, in just a bit. I'll ask Haywood on that one. But yeah, huge shout out to him. I don't know what team he plays for exactly, but I'm assuming the team has to have a ridiculous name. Okay, so now we have a switch here again, as
yeah,
it seems like Burn Man, they're leaving one unit here to kind of give them the idea that they're running the same strat. They have two units pushing up over here, Burn, as well as a couple of units over here right by this road.
Yeah, so Fulcrum, in response to what they saw the previous round, which was initially Burn All Empires lining up along the tracks and waiting to push in, have moved to the middle on Burn All Empires' side of the tracks. What they don't know is that all of Burn All Empires went to the left side of the map.
Yeah.
And they are now just pushing up towards where they were.
Yeah, so it kind of just reverse rolls here, which is something you kind of have to anticipate. And Burn All Empires, they're going to be hanging out real close at the edge of the map there. No one identifying anyone just yet, as well as Absolute Royal here, as you can see.
Yeah.
He's hanging out really close. There's going to be one guy in the middle that gets spotted. So there is a spot there between the two. I believe that was going... Ooh, wait a minute.
You go. Making moves.
Yeah, there you go. Hugo Maximus able to take out one. That was going to be SBM Hawk there with that perishing to close that kill out. Big win for them to at least just give themselves a little bit of an advantage here as far as you know, player counts are concerned. But really, when it's T1s, you can't really say, like, oh, huge advantage, because right. it really isn't. I mean, T1's
sort of
a spotter. Much.
Extra eyes are now disappeared.
Yeah, extra eyes. But here, well, actually, maybe I'm downplaying it a lot, right? Because the T1s, the reason why they run two, it is important to cover those angles on the map there. Mm-hmm. And I also want to point out here that there's going to be one player hanging out all the way at the top. That's going to be F0X. And look here. You're going to see a rush right inside of the base. They're going to take out F0X. Now they're going to move right inside, and no one's going to be there for a response here. The base capture is about to begin. I don't know if anyone's going to be able to push up here. As Soviet, he's going to have to run his way over and chug through with this T-69, making his way around. They're about to cross that halfway point. They only have one unit that's going to be inside of their base, the enemy base, the cabin. That's going to be Relic there with that T-1. And he's not going to be able to really do much here. Soviet's going to get interrupted here by G-Forcer. G-Forcer on the prowl. He's going to find Soviet, trying to see if he can take him out. But Soviet opting to just move ahead instead.
Excellent.
We're currently sitting at 64.
Taking out Zone Delta. Only two left in the hill now, Azrael and Revenant. Azrael's been doing a great job of using essentially Revenant as cover there. Good shots from Revenant on Soviet, exchanging blows. Who is going to go down first? Looks like Revenant taking a lot of damage. Only Azrael left in the hill now, takes half of his health with one shot. And has now Absolute Royal coming in. Soviet weak, but still viable.
And look at Absolute Royal moving in like a boss, able to clear that one out. Big win there for them. G-Forcer, last person left alive with that perishing. He's going to be up top. That was going to be such a big play there as they converge on the base.
Yep.
And that is pretty much going to do it. If they take out G-Forcer, that will pretty much be GG. What a run there. They went for the base. Soviet moved in, able to clear out a lot of units. Absolute Royal came around and did a lot of damage here, thus clearing out the base. And they are going to have their scout. That is going to be Relix, who's going to be sitting there trying to cap it, getting 1 point per second, because he is worth only one. And that is going to do it, folks. Congratulations to the guys in Fulcrum. They are going to move on to China.
That was a sick, sick match. I think we saw what Burn All Empires initially wanted to do in that game one, which was use them AMXs to rush the base.
Yeah.
They did so, and it looked like they were going to take the base,
but
a great response. Response out of Soviet.
The fault lied there, in a sense, with G-Force. He could not take out Soviet in time. And then Absolute Royal came, because they were positioned.
Right.
They were positioned to be able to stop anyone from coming up on them from the south there. So Absolute Royal, he pushes in, because Soviet is just peppering them with shots on the other side. It was nothing that they could do there, thus eliminating them on that one. What a play. I told you it was going to go by quick.
Oh, yeah.
And that's
going
to do it, man. Awesome stuff. That was fun as hell. I had a blast casting that. Oh, man. I was. And there was Kevin, I think, that was our producer, that right in the camera.
Chilling.
Just no, none of care in the world. Guys, let us know how we did. I had a great time with that one.
That was
really
a blast.
Fun.
Absolutely. It was a blast. Do you get it? Do you get the pun,
though? It was
a blast.
There
we go.
Awful. All right, guys. Well, I think we're going to have an interview with the winner.
Yep.
And then in a little bit, we're gonna take a quick commercial break, and then when we come back, we're gonna have more content, World of Tanks stuff. Don't go anywhere. Congratulations to Fulcrum. They're gonna go to the United States to represent China. Frank, any last thoughts?
It's great play out of both teams. Congratulations to both of them for being out here. And you know, just to remind guys, coming up next, we'll have Street Fighter 4, so be sure to stay tuned. We'll see you in a bit.
All right. See you in a little bit.